Okay, plant friends, today we are doing an update on all things lettuce grow. I've had this here now for 2.5 months. You can click the link above to check out the lettuce grow setup and initial overview of my first 30 days with the product. I have to say, I'm still as obsessed with it today as I was before.
Bloom and Grow YouTube show.
This thing is freaking amazing. There are a few things I wanted to draw to your attention after living with this thing for a minute. Some interesting things. So the light capacity for it, like now, as you notice, the herbs have really grown in. We've got so many violas. As the plants grow into the structure, it actually is a lot more like pleasant to have in your light space. If you noticed in the first video, because there were less plants, there was a lot more light, which was awesome. But this is also kind of a really cool vibe. It like highlights the green and I'm really into it. So I got more seeds. We have been eating and harvesting from this almost every day. My smoothie tower has been going great. My green smoothies have never been tastier. And there are a few plants that I wanted to share with you that I'm loving and a few plants that I'm not loving as much in this indoor setup. So the first tower of herbs is amazing. I put mint in my water and my smoothies every day. I'm obsessed. The second level, the strawberries have been fun to grow and see the flowers, but we're not getting a lot of fruit for the real estate of the two pods that we have. And they throw off all of these runners, which are helpful, but I feel like then the runners don't get light. Like the runners are all over and it like looks cool and it's wild and it's fun to see all these little strawberry runners, but then they're outside of the lights. So I'm either tucking them in or I'm cutting them off and I'm finding that even though I love strawberries, for the bang for your buck indoor growing, I think that we're probably gonna end up just keeping these two pods and not adding and maybe harvesting them and then doing something else. For me, I'm really loving the lettuce and the greens portion of this. We have had so many delicious butter lettuce Asian chicken tacos inspired by PF Chang's. Oh my God, there's an amazing recipe from Skinny Taste. I'll put it below. We've been harvesting lettuce almost every day. Growing these snap peas have been really fun. Yesterday we made a delicious stir fry with tatsoi, bok choy, snap peas, and spinach. So I feel like that's where, just personally, that's the food that I really wanna grow indoors that I really like coming over, snipping off, and then throwing into dinner or in my smoothie every day. So I think this is gonna kind of turn into an exclusive like smoothie tower, lettuce tower moment for us, especially as we embark in growing season. So because we've harvested a whole bunch of the lettuce, like the spinach isn't cut and come again. You grow the spinach, you eat the spinach, and then it's done. We've ordered some new seedlings. So in this one, we have more kale, another pea, because I'm really enjoying the peas, and another thyme, because our thyme got a little funky. And then in this one, we have baby lettuce mix, bok choy, 2 butter lettuce, because we're living for our butter lettuce tacos, and then 2 more kale. So I'm really going to turn this into a smoothie tower plus a butter lettuce taco tower and some peas, because the peas are really giving me a lot of joy. It's so fun to watch a pea flower and then the petals open and then there's like this little pea and then the pea just gets bigger and bigger, and the species of pea that lettuce grow, the whatever we're eating is the tastiest pea we've ever had. It's so sweet, it's like candy. So when I set up the lettuce grow, I wanted to take the pods out because there's serious root porn in these things. It's unbelievable just seeing this, like how many roots are growing on the inside of it. It's wild. So I wanted to do the whole process of removing and then setting it up again with you. So we're taking out the spinach. Oopsies. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Like that's the spinach, like gross. Those are the spinach roots. What else are we taking out? So we're done with the spinach. We're done with the spinach. Oh, I can harvest some of that still. I harvested kale for my smoothie earlier today. I mean, look at those roots. Look at, this is my wingspan. That's like 3 feet of roots. Holy moly, look at that. I started 2 tomatoes from seed in the back, which are doing really good. So now I'm just gonna do a little rearranging and get my new seedling set up. Okay, so I just finished a little bit of rearranging. Our tomato plant has flowers. I'm so excited. I definitely need to do a little bit more rearranging. I don't know if you can see, but there's actually a lot of the herbs on the top have grown outside of the grow ring. So I'm going to trim those up. 4 kales, 2 butter lettuce, 2 tomatoes that I started from seed. Yeah, so this thing is growing like crazy. It's been so much fun. I've also gotten some questions about how to mix nutrients, so I wanted to show you that. The way that the nutrients work, at the end of every week, you should budget probably 7 to 10 minutes of maintenance. That's literally all it takes. As the roots uptake water and also it evaporates, the water reservoir loses a certain amount of water every week. So I spend about 5 minutes filling up my big Brita and dumping it into the water reservoir. You can do it with a hose, but I don't have a hose to do it with. And then you mix a new form of the nutrient solution and you add it into the reservoir. Okay, so one tip about the nutrients that I've gotten asked. The nutrients are simple. They send you the nutrients. You are supposed to scoop a certain amount into your reservoir every week. But a trick that I learned on the Lettuce Grow Facebook group, which is unbelievable, is pre-dissolve the nutrients into a smaller amount of water and then dump that water into your reservoir. Run the pump, get it going, mix it up, then do the next set of nutrients, put them in the reservoir, run the pump, mix it up, then once the reservoir is mixed, you do your pH, and then you measure your pH, then you do your pH down, and then you let the pump do the work for you for mixing the water. So that's been super helpful because it's a lot of water and it's stressful. So here is one of the nutrients. Every week I am supposed to put, because the app tells me to and I do whatever the app says, 1.5 scoops of each set of nutrients in the water. I've got my little little baby water. This is my very scientific, extremely fancy method of getting the nutrients right. There goes one. Here goes the other. Mixy, mixy, mix. I feel like Lettuce Grow, all of my Lettuce Grow content should be sponsored by Brita, if that makes any sense. Because I feel like my biggest thing that I use for Lettuce Grow is the Brita to transport the water from my kitchen sink into my Lettuce Grow reservoir. But apparently it's very easy. From what I've read on the Facebook group, all my friends on the Facebook group, it's very simple to like rig your hose up to do your weekly filling. But it's okay, I could use the exercise. Doing my fancy mixing technique, and then you dump it in. And then I'm just gonna run the pump. This will mix, and then in a little bit, I'll do the pH down, but I literally use the same technique with the pH down, so I'm not gonna waste your time showing you. Okay, plant friends, that is my update for now. Still 10 out of 10, our experience with Lettuce Grow. I mean, we love it. We're having so much fun growing our own food. It's literally, my smoothies in the morning are literally living room to table. Like, it doesn't get more local than that. And I'm excited now that I've kind of gotten the lay of the land. I'm excited to maybe experiment with some varieties from Territorial Seed Company and get my own. You can start your own seeds. I ordered plugs on the internet. Lettuce Grow actually gives you the types of plugs to order, and you can order your own plugs and order the recyclable, reusable baskets for Lettuce Grow and start your own seeds. That's how I have 2 micro dwarf tomato plants growing, what I'm super excited about. And if you're interested in seeing those harvests, you can follow me on Instagram. So I hope you have fun in your growing endeavors, plant friends, whether it's food indoors or outdoors or houseplants, whatever it is. I hope that with them, you keep blooming and keep growing.